Hi, my name is Griffin Hodnett. I'm the product manager for compact automation in the Americas for METTLER TOLEDO. Today we're going to talk about how to configure IND360 for a multi-ACM scale type. We have separate videos available for how to wire up the multi-ACM scale option. We have another video for how to complete this configuration with the load advisor option available to you. This video is for those who do not have the load advisor option installed on their multi-ACM unit. And again, we have another video even that shows you how to connect to the web server of the IND360. None of that other content will be covered in this video today. We will purely be going through the setup of IND360 through the web interface. Let's go ahead and get started. So here we're taking a look at our system here. We can see in this picture-in-picture, we have a platform down here in the bottom. With a way module in each one of the four corners. So this is a four load cell system. Again, this IND360 is set to factory defaults, and we're just going to take a look at what it takes to set up this system. So first thing I notice here is I've got a flashing red light, which means I've got an error. This is very common to see. This is telling me that I don't have a PLC connected. So if you do have a PLC in your system, feel free to leave this enabled. But for our video, I will go ahead and disable this quickly just by going to Supervision and Disable. Okay, so now we see that red light has gone away, but we can also see we have zero weight on here, but we can still see we're getting 0.46 kg in the web interface. If I place this 5 kg test weight on there, we go to 0.78, so we're nowhere near where we'd like to be in terms of weighing performance right now. So of course we need to set up this system. So to do that, I'm going to go to scale and then type. So what I want to do is I want to enter in the number of active load cells. So in this case, it is four. If, for example, I had three, then we would just need to select checkboxes for which of the load cells we had wired in. But since it's four, it'll automatically populate all four of these. So I'll go ahead and select set. The load cell shift adjusts, so we want this, this 5 kg test weight to weigh 5 kg whether it's here, or anywhere on this platform. So the shift adjust is going to help us make sure that that happens. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the shift adjust on this right side, and the adjust mode is going to be by cell. So we'll hit OK. It's asking me to empty the scale. It is empty, so I will select OK. And now it's telling me to place it on load cell number one. This is where we want to be careful. So the multi-ACM junction box has specific labels for load cells 1, 2, 3, and 4. You can also see that on the outside of that junction box. So we just want to make sure that when we're placing this test weight, we know where load cell number one is. I happen to know that it is right here. So I've placed that, and I will select OK. And we'll simply repeat this process for all four of the load cells. Okay, so that finished successfully. So now we can remove that, and what we want to do is we want to set our capacity and increment values. So since I happen to be in the US, I will set my units to pounds. And my capacity will be, let's say, 100 pounds in this case. And I only need 0.01 increment value. So we're going to make sure we select set. Otherwise, those units will not be written to the IND360. And we'll continue on to the next tab, which is the calibration. So of course, we want to set up whatever our local geocode is. We want to use our units. Here I will use kg since the test weight I have is 5 kg test weight. So I'll select set. And the first thing we want to do is we want to do a zero adjustment. So anything that's going to be permanently on the system, so if there's a tank permanently attached, we want that tank in place. But for this one, we're saying that this, this platform here is the permanent scale system. So we say this is our zero adjustment point. So let's go ahead and start that. And that is now completed. Now the next step, we have a few options. We could do a step adjust for incremental calibration. We could do rapid cal. We could do cal free. All of these have their pros and their cons. But what we're going to do is we're going to do the classic test weight adjustment, which is still the most accurate way to calibrate and perform adjustments. So here I'm going to select a 5 kgs and make sure I read that it tells me to place the test load on the scale and then start the adjustment. So I will place that and then select start. Okay, so it tells me my current weight is 5. I'm happy with that. So I will select done to save that value. Okay, so now the final thing we're going to do here is we're going to come down to maintenance, and I want to make sure that I can detect if one of my load cells were to become disconnected. So I'm going to go to configure and view, and then this feature called load cell supervision here down at the bottom. I want to enable this, and I need to put in the average rated cell output of the 4 load cells. So these all happen to be 2 millivolt per volt load cells, so I'm okay sticking with this value. It knows that there are 4 load cells connected, so it's going to read what the load cell resistance is. So now we can see it gets a reading of 394 ohms on these particular load cells. You may find different values for you. As long as your load cells are connected correctly, you should be able to proceed with this value. So we'll select OK. So now it remembers this. So if there are any sort of disconnections of those load cells, that will now be an error, and it will be able to tell us which load cell is disconnected. So let's quickly take a look back at our home screen. So we can see our weight value in pounds. And what we want to make sure is that as we move this around to different points on the scale, that we're getting the same weight value each time. So that's telling us our shift adjustment worked and everything seems to be going okay. So with that, we can see how easy it is to set up the IND360 MultiACM from factory defaults and get started weighing. Thank you for your time.